Environmental group Greenpeace not in favor of President Marcos's decision to extend the service contract of Malambaya gas field. For Greenpeace, it just shows the administration's bias towards dirty energy. A consortium member, Prime Energy, meanwhile commits to ensure a stable and cleaner power supply for the country. Prime Infra Chairman Enrique Razon believes the latest development will help the country achieve energy security and independence. For more on this, we are joined by Greenpeace campaigner Kevin Yu. Good morning, Kevin. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Nikki, and thanks for inviting us in the show.
Great. So first off, Yu said that the Malampaya contract extension shows the Marcos administration's bias towards a dirty energy. Why the term dirty?
Yes, so obviously what has happened is that this is an extension of and business as usual approach for the government. Even from the previous administration, they have been constantly saying that they are technology agnostic in terms of energy resource, but we've seen more headways in terms of fossil fuel projects such as Malampaya, coal projects, and even liquefied natural gas, or what we call fossil gas projects that has been expanding in the past years. And this is highly apparent also in this administration.
Mm-hmm. And the president extended the Malampaya gas field service contract to 15 years, you know, adding mandates to conduct exploratory drilling spa for fossil gas. What are the conditions under this contract?
Within this contract, aside from extending the existing Malampaya exploration facility, it will have three exploration sites with an estimated of 5 billion each. No, but there's no guarantee that we will have an additional source of gas in this contract. So this is quite risky for the side of the government or even the contractors, no? Because there's no assurance that there will be an additional capacity from the existing facility, which has only around with an estimated of 210 billion cubic feet of remaining deposit. So that means based on the estimate of Department of Energy, it will last until probably around 2027. But there's another study that have shown that we only have around until next year in terms of the supply of Malampaya. So this is a risky deal for the Philippine government with no with obvious alternative in terms of pursuit energy generation.
So this latest move has locked us in long-term to fossil gas. Can you tell us the risks involved here, also in terms of environmental issues?
Yes, for natural gas, it is considered as a fossil fuel. So that means it will emit emissions as well. So that means it can contribute to extending the or expanding the climate crisis. So because it is really important right now that we focus our resources, our time, and our projects in terms of expanding renewable energy in the country. So the 15-year extension will lock us in again to fossil fuel that should have been provided space for the energy transition to renewable energy. Mm-hmm. So another problem with that is that these projects have a tendency to have environmental impacts as well, no? Although LNG, Malampaya particularly, you cannot see it visually, but there has some emissions in terms of its operation.
Mm-hmm. And your group also adds that our country's expensive fossil gas pipeline, which includes allowing a new foreign-owned fossil gas import terminal, also exposes us to the extreme price volatility of the fuel globally. Can you expound on this?
Yes. So for natural gas and LNG, we've seen globally, especially in the COVID lockdown, that we've seen price volatility globally, especially in the onset of the Ukraine crisis. Prices of LNG have been one of the most expensive. So that means that there's no guarantee that this project will reduce the price of electricity, but based on trends, it will actually expose us to higher prices of electricity. So that's an additional problem in terms of engaging with these kinds of projects. Although Malampaya is sourced here in the Philippines, but it can also expand, no, new facilities for LNG extraction. That means that it will be more expensive for the electric consumers in the Philippines.
What your group is pushing for is that instead of chasing after fossil gas projects, our government should hasten a just transition towards renewable energy. Tell us more on how we can actually go about this transition.
Yes, currently the government is aiming for a 50% renewable energy expansion by 2030. So the best step, no, rather than focusing on extending contracts and providing more projects for fossil fuel projects, is that we need to focus on expanding new solar and wind projects in the pipeline. Because the Malampaya extension that means that it will provide less opportunity for the growth of renewable energy expansion. So we need to expand further this 50% target and to make it happen immediately. So that's what's happening right now, that the more we time and investment we put to fossil fuel projects, the less space for renewable energy to expand immediately.
Lastly, before we let you go, how long do you see our current energy crisis going on with the way that we are going about solving things and with how the administration is handling?
So in terms of the Malampaya contract extension, it will be another problem along the way, no? So within the 15-year contract, there's no guarantee it can provide the additional 2,000 megawatts it will provide currently. So that means it will be another problem maybe 2 or 5 years from now. So the only way to solve this is to utilize energy resources that have no deadline and depletion in terms of fuel. And obviously that will come from solar and wind that has proven itself to be cheaper and have no price volatility in the Philippines and globally.
All right. On that note, thank you for sharing your insights with us, Kevin. You stay safe and we'll continue hoping for the best.
Thank you, Ms. Tiki.